Please join us. The buffer has been switched off and you're now free to move about the cabin.
My outlook in life has changed over the past 2 years after coming to Australia. I think I've become more matured as an adult and yet retaining the childlike faith in me, I would say. I think I would have to say I'm more concentrated about my studies right now. I think more about my career and my future, as well as marriage itself with my girlfriend. I think all this plays a big part in my life right now and things that I'm working right now. It's very immediate because I think these are things that I want to fulfill after I'm done studying. So yeah, I think that's how much it has changed. Because I think previously I'm more carefree and more... I have no idea what's going on and I have no goals to really work towards too. But just to, you know, get myself out there in the working world. But with this in mind, I think I have a clearer picture of what I need to work towards too. The highlights of my youth, I think I've been blessed with many good friends. Friends that taught me to see what the world is, as well as my parents. I think I'm really blessed to have this taught to me and to be able to let myself fall out in the real world and then get picked up by my friends or my parents. I think that's the biggest highlight of my childhood. Low would be, I think, losing my uncle. Yeah, he was like a father to me because my dad was away for 15 years. So in turn, my uncle, who is my father's brother, he took care of me of that 15 years and we've gotten really close. And I was really devastated by his loss to cancer. He actually literally felt like losing a father, yeah. So yeah, I'd say that's a whole of my life. Yeah. I think the first skill that I would really, really like to excel in would probably be in academics, because I'm really bad in my studies and I think this is something I have always wanted or always admired. Especially friends who could play hard and yet study hard as well. I think that's one skill that I would really like to have if, you know, given another chance that I could wake up tomorrow. Second skill, I think I would be to be more vocal, I would say, to be more vocal about my emotions. I'm pretty reserved as a person, maybe because I'm a type 9. Peacemaker for you, for those of you who do not know, and I tend to put the feeling of others first before I put myself, and I think that is something that I wouldn't like to change, but I would like to have it in another aspect. And yeah, and the third skill, maybe to be more committed in sports, to really go out and play at a level where I would say either semi-pro or to pro professional level. I guess God has already blessed me with the ability to, you know, to really play sports well and to play any sports. Especially, I think this has been a very big part of my life, and the sad thing about it is that I have never gotten it to a level where I could really see how good am I. Maybe if I could wake up tomorrow, I would say, like, you know, to have that drive to try to see how good am I. And I think, like, all these thoughts that has been going on, like, I'm a person who takes time off during showers and or probably when I'm taking a dump. I know it's a bit weird, but yeah, I think best during these times. And yeah, my heart on me, Huddle through my heart on me has really helped me to take time off to just, you know, think about these questions in life that, you know, you don't really think about unless you sit still and or unless you're in a zone where you feel comfortable, you feel relaxed, or you feel by yourself, you know. So yeah, I think my heart on me has really helped me quite a bit.